We don't want to ride in the dark.
I'm caught. Welcome to the spirit world of New Lanark. Do you believe in ghosts?
Oh my god.
Maybe you can't see us, but we're right here. We live on in the walls around you. The floors we walked on. The things that you touched.
Look. Over there. Over there.
Yeah.
Down that one.
Yeah, I'm looking.
Down that one.
That one. What's he talking about? Is it that one?
That one. The green.
Okay.
So what is my story? Annie McLeod, born New Lanark, 1810. Dies. We'll never mind that.
Now, in 1820, I'm 10 years old and I work in the mill. I could have stayed at school until I was 12. Mr. Rome would have liked that. But we need the money, so I left to work in the mill. The mill's not a bad place to work, but you have to take care, mind. The machines didn't stop for no one, so there's highway accidents, and sometimes worse. I work as a piecer, joining the broken threads. I have to go right onto the mules, and I crawl for miles every day. It hurts my knees. I don't like all the cotton dust and fluff. It sticks to our hair and clothes, so we look like snowmen.
That's ghosts. Ghosts.
But we only work 10.5 hours in the day now, and we have meal breaks for breakfast and dinner.
But we have to work 6 days a week, mind, and we only have 2 days holiday in the whole year. Everyone else in the family works, well, except for my wee brothers and my wee sister Femi. They go to school. My wee sister Femi. She's only two, so she plays in the nursery. Soon she'll be taught by Mr. Buchanan. He was a weaver and he played the flute and taught us songs and rhymes and riddles. He was aye cheery and we all liked him. School was great fun. We're taught upstairs in the lovely big rooms. The teachers asked a lot of questions, and so did we. And we had lots of different things to do. Now that I work in the mill, I can still go to school after I finish work. There's lots of older folk go too. Have you met Mr. Rowan yet? He's the mill owner. He's strict, but he's fair, and better than most, my mother says. But the work's still hard. I get very tired and hungry. When he's no away, Miss Rowe makes a tour of inspection every day. Sometimes his son comes with him. In the mill, he hardly says a word. He just looks at you, then at your monitor, then back at you. Those wee bits of wood hanging above you, he calls them his silent monitors. There are four colours to tell you how you've done. If it's white, you're all right. But if your work's bad, if you put up a black, as we see, he'd give you a look as we'd freeze the cloud. My granny worked as a spinner in Mill 3 until it burnt down last year. But now she's ill and has had to stop working. She and my father still talk to each other in the Gaelic. but the noise of the machines has made her dead, so she doesn't hear much.
We stay in the new buildings. The Kirkholms live across the coast from us, and the Stuarts live down the stair. We have two rooms. There's my mother, my father, and my big sister, and her man, with two wee brothers and another sister. And not forgetting the bear.
There's 10 of us sleep in the two rooms. Us bairns sleep in the hurleys that we pull out from under the set-in beds. Sometimes I wonder what it'd be like to live in a house where there are more rooms than people, like Mr. Rowan does. Mrs. Livingston up the stair looks after the bairn. She's even older than grandmother. I clean the stairs for her when it's her turn and get her messages from the store. In the village, everything is done by the clock. Mr. Rowan won't have us being late for work. We have to wake up at 5:30 in the morning and start work at 6. We stop at 9:00 and come home for our porridge. Then we have to work another 4 hours before our dinner. He has all these rules and regulations about getting on with our neighbours and keeping the stairs clean, the windows polished and the walls whitewashed. It's all for our own good, he says, and folk from the committee come round to make sure we do it all. We call him the bug hunters. But he looks after us as well. We have a sickness fund so that if we're ill, the doctor can see us for free. Outside the mill, Mr. Rowan talks a lot. When he opened the institute, he talked and talked. Nobody worked that day. He talks about the new system and the end of evil and misery. I like that. I don't work on Sunday though. My friend Isabel's not in the mill yet. She's only 8. We play together. We like to play with our guards and queens. One of my favourite games is Peebers. Though I miss being at school. I like them dancing best, and the visitors, I like to see it too. In the summer, my mother takes some of the washing down to the riverbank. Sometimes I help a bit, but the blankets are aye too heavy for me to lift when they're wet. Best of all is when we play down by the river. We have to be really careful, mind. The tide's very fast. You should see it coming over Coral Inn. The water turns the water wheels in the mills and makes all the machines go. I don't really understand how it works, but I know, because as long as the wheels keep turning, we keep making cotton, and that keeps Mr. Rowan happy. Mr. Owen wants us to be happy too, mind. And I think we are. New Lanark is special because of Mr. Owen. Sometimes there's as many as 60 visitors in one day. My father says we must be famous. Maybe sometimes his ideas are a wee bit strange. Maybe sometimes we don't understand him. But he is fair and kind. I think he's on our side. So there's my story, our story, the story of the people of New Anna. You may leave us now, but our ghosts will aye be here. We are the past, but we're part of the future too. We live on in the walls around you. The forge we walked on. The things that we touched.